polling papers, you know, for the six positions, and then you do your polling, and then after that you are given your mark. You have the mark on the hand to show that you are not you cannot repeat the exercise in another polling center. I'm quite impressed by the decision. I don't know. I hope it is being done the same across, that nobody is being turned away from exercising this right. But anybody who is not on the register, because one of the challenges that people have experienced is finding their name in the register. But these particular polling center have decided, and I think this must have been given a go ahead by the officials, that if you don't find your name, you are yes allowed to exercise your right, you are allowed to vote, but they retain your ID, which they will receive at the end of the day when the polling has stopped, so that they are not able to go and vote anywhere else, because that was the fear, that if we write people just on exercise, you know, on the who are not in the register, they can do it in several other polling centers. But the fact that once the first place that they vote, the ID is retained, then they cannot be able to do that more than once.
What is the number of registered voters in this particular polling center?
In this center, I'm told it's about 391. And up to now, there are well over 200, or over half of them, you know, have already voted by I'm told in less than 2 hours, you know, quite over half of the voters had already cast their vote.
So as scheduled, we expect this exercise to be over by 5 in the evening.
At least I'm sure in those areas that have had no issues. As I've said, I've been informed that there are certain places that have some issues. Even in this my constituency, areas of Kamungei have got issues, Kabletunda ward, because the number of MCAs were so many, it looks like they have not all been reflected in the ballot paper. So I'm told that is being addressed. They are aware and something is being done about it. Also in Mogogosiek, there were not enough ballots in quite a number of the polling centers in Mogogosiek ward. So those ones, the officials we've spoken, I've spoken with Waweru, who is from the National Elections Board, and some of the arrows, and that is being addressed. Yeah. So those pockets of issues, but on the whole, generally, I think voting is going on smoothly.
Well, my very last question. There have been allegations of marked ballot papers which have been found in a place called Matarmet. I don't know if you're aware of those allegations.
No, I have not heard. Where is that Matarmet?
It is in Merigi.
In Merigi. And they were supposed to be marked in favor of who?
Well, as it is now, they're saying that they've been marked in favor of a particular candidate. So I was thinking maybe you've been made aware of those particular allegations.
No, none. What I had been made aware of was the earlier one, what was going to happen on Friday. Yes, I had been made and actually shown some of the you know, supposedly pre-marked. Yes, they were pre-marked for my opponent. Those ones I was shown. But today, I haven't had any. In fact, it's you who's telling me about this new one, but I will now investigate and find out the truth of it.
Well, thank you very much. That has been Dr. Joyce Laboso, who is vying for Jubilee ticket, of course, to represent Jubilee.
All right, Jeff Kirui, our reporter there, speaking to Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Joyce Laboso, who is vying to become the next governor of Bomet County via the Jubilee ticket. But of course, the first step is winning the primaries that are currently ongoing. Now, in